has to subtract, we have 2.868 minus 6.2. So the first thing to recognize here is that we're subtracting a larger value from a smaller value, and therefore this difference is going to be negative. And now to find this difference, we'll write the difference as a sum, and then use the formal rules for adding signed decimals to find the sum, as well as show the sum on the number line. We can write this difference as a sum because subtracting a number is the same as adding the opposite. So because subtracting b is the same as adding negative b, we can write 2.868 minus 6.2 as 2.868 plus negative 6.2. Now that we have the difference as a sum, we'll find this sum using the formal rules for adding decimals. And because we have a positive plus a negative, we'll be using the rules here for adding two decimals with different signs. So step one is to determine the absolute value of both decimals. So we need to find the absolute value of positive 2.868 and the absolute value of negative 6.2. The absolute value of a number is a number's distance from zero. And because distance is always positive, absolute value is always positive. So the absolute value of positive 2.868 is positive 2.868. And the absolute value of negative 6.2 is positive 6.2. Step two, we subtract the smaller value from the larger value. So now we subtract 2.868 from 6.2. Let's write this difference vertically. So we have 6.2, lining up the corresponding place values, we have minus 2.868. Notice how 6.2 has one decimal place and 2.868 has three decimal places. We can add a zero to the hundredths and thousandths place value for 6.2. We can do this because 2/10 is equal to 200 thousandths. Before subtracting, let's move the decimal point down to the difference. And now we subtract like we normally do. Notice how we need to perform an exchange here before subtracting. So we go all the way over to the 2, perform an exchange by making the 2 a 1, and then we'd have a 9 here and a 10 here. So 10 minus 8 is 2, 9 minus 6 is 3. We need to perform another exchange here. The 6 becomes a 5, and we have 11 minus 8, which is 3, and 5 minus 2 is 3. So this difference is positive 3.332, but we still need to determine the sign of the original sum, which equals the original difference. The sign of the sum is the original sign of the decimal with the larger absolute value. So because negative 6.2 has the larger absolute value, this sum, which equals this difference, is negative 3.332. So again, this is the same as the original difference. And again, it should make sense as it's negative because the negative 6.2 is outweighing the positive 2.868, and because we're subtracting a larger value from a smaller value. Let's also model this on the number line. So to model 2.868, we start at 0 and move right 2.868 units, which would be just to the left of positive 3. And then because we're adding negative 6.2 or subtracting positive 6.2 from here, we would move left 6.2 units. Which brings us to negative 3.332, which would be just to the right of negative 3.5. So positive 2.868 plus negative 6.2, or positive 2.868 minus positive 6.2 equals negative 3.332. I hope you found this helpful.